So if you talk about quantification, sort of, is there a formula for risk or the risk exposure that we have? Risk is really, we said, how likely, the probability of an adverse security event happening. So you first thing you have to say, well, there is a threat out there. They may come after me. I have some controls in place, but they may be able to get around them. And actually, I might get compromised, may experience a breach or whatever it is. So what is the likelihood of that? So you have to have the probability. Then you have to multiply by the impact of that adverse event. It's going to cost me $10 million to deal with that. Well, if the probability is half, that's way too much. But if it is half and it's going to cost you $10 million, your risk is $5 million. We said quantifying, of course, you had to quantify both of these quantities, the probability as well as the impact or the loss you're going to suffer as a result of the adverse event that we're talking about. So there's something called risk leverage because we like to reduce our risk exposure. And one way we can do that is by having some sort of a control in place. The control we know comes with a cost. So risk leverage is for a given control. Talking about quantifying it and then sort of if it's too high, you don't like it, we can try to reduce it by putting in one or more controls. So if when you put a control, you can ask, you know, what the risk leverage of that control is. So the way to sort of compute that is that you say, what was my risk exposure before or without the control that is under consideration? That's without deploying that. Minus the risk exposure after this control is deployed. Okay, this difference really is nothing but the amount by which the risk is reduced because of this control that we're going to put into our enterprise. So that's the decrease in risk divided by the cost of that control that we're talking about. We've been saying we have to have cost-benefit analysis. This is, you know, this is how much risk. This is what happens to risk if we do something about unacceptable level of risk. So this is the cost of that control that we have in the denominator here. So if you divide the reduction in risk by the cost, that gives you the risk leverage. For any control that you have, risk leverage should be greater than one. It makes no sense for it to be less than one because in that case, you're saying your risk reduction actually is smaller than the cost. It's not very smart that you pay more and overall, you're not in a better place than you were before in terms of the cost and whatever risk that you have. So this is how we compute the leverage. And whenever you talk about a particular control, if you do this and the value is not greater than one, then of course that control should not be considered.